A lot of contemporary ultra-wide-angle lenses are simply too large for the 100mm system. And so Lee have come up with a solution for that, the SW150 system. It was originally designed for the Nikon 14-24mm lens, but is now being adapted and developed for a number of other lenses as well. And you can find out which lenses those are by looking at the Lee Filters website. The core of the system is the adapter, and that comes in three parts. This is the box, and it has an instruction with it, but I'd like to show you how that works in practice. Initially, when you take it out, you may not be able to tell it is three parts, but you'll see underneath that there is a lugged inner ring. This is called the front ring in the instructions. And at the moment, it's all put together. So we have to unscrew it like this. And it's helpful if you keep everything in the same order as you take the elements apart. So if I put those down like that and note the orientation of the ring. This, by the way, is a Samyang 14mm lens. And each of these adapters is designed specifically for the lens in question. The four lugs on this adapter ensure that the front ring stays in the correct place. Now, holding the lens by the petal lens hood, I'm going to reassemble the compression ring, which is the red one, and then finally the locking ring, like this. The rings are all metal and very, very solid. And once it's locked down, you'll find that the whole thing feels extremely strong and robust. You probably won't want to be taking it off every time you put it in the camera bag, but there we are, very solid unit. The SW150 Mark II filter holder comes with two filter slots and a light shield and can be fitted onto the adapter like this. And like all Lee system filter holders, it can be rotated through 360 degrees. Well, as ever with landscape photography, most photographers will be using the grads as their primary filter. And they're available in three different densities for the SW150. That's 1, 2, and 3 stop strengths in hard and in soft gradations. And they can be used very straightforwardly. They are large, so require just a little bit more care in use. And once they're in, it's very easy to see the effect through the viewfinder. If you have live view, you may prefer to use that as well. And there we are. Well, a polarizer is a fairly essential item for most landscape photographers. And there is a polarizer for the SW150 system. It is square, but perhaps slightly confusingly, it is a circular polarizer. Now, if you're familiar with polarizers, you'll know there are two different types, a circular and a linear. And without going into great detail, the circular is the one that's available. Generally, that's better for cameras which have automated metering systems. So it fits the holder in the normal way, but it is important when you fit it, and this is explained in the instructions, that the printed lettering is top left from you, the photographer's point of view, your point of view. And once it's in, it can be rotated and the effect can be very clearly seen as you would hope. And that's fine if you're using the polarizer on its own, but what if you want to use it with a graduated filter? I think it's important to emphasize that the graduated filter will limit your options somewhat, and that's because the position of the grad, which I'm placing in the outside grooves, is going to be the most important determinant of the exact angle of the holder. So let's say we needed it like that. Well, now we're limited to that angle with the polarizer, which might not give optimum polarization. But we do have one other possibility, which is to turn the polarizer through 90 degrees. And generally, there's a significant difference in that orientation. And then it's up to you as a photographer to choose which is more effective if you're going to continue to use the polarizer. It's worth saying that if you had a circular mount polarizer at the front, the polarizer would be so large that the whole rig would be almost impractical. So although there's a slight compromise in the use of the polarizer with another filter, it's still an extremely useful filter. One of the advantages of the Mark II version of the SW150 system is the light shield. And this means that we can now use stopping filters like the little stopper and the big stopper and get perfect technical results. It's important when inserting these filters to note that they have an asymmetrical back design. It's important because the grooves at the side are the ones that coincide with the filter guide rails. So looking at the holder, and I'm going to show you this from the back so you can see how it works. Inserting the holder, always in the back grooves so that it is snug to the light shield. Push it down gently, but don't just keep pushing once you get to this point. It's very important as the foam reaches the edge of the light shield, apply a little bit of pressure against the filter, and that will ease the light shield past the foam trap. And now there's a perfect seal between the light shield and the filter itself, and it's ready to shoot. Having said all of that, once you're ready to shoot, you should still, if there's any direct sunlight particularly, still aim to shield the filter rig from direct sunlight. If you're the owner of a Mark I holder and you want to use long exposure light stopping filters like the big stopper or the little stopper, you can now do so by using the light shield, which is available as a separate item. And it couldn't be easier to fit. It is important to get the orientation right because it has these grooves which coincide with the guide rails of the filter holder. Just pop them in one side and on the other, and there it is. Also available for the SW150 system is a field pouch. Here, it comes with a neck strap and a belt loop at the back, but probably most importantly for landscape photographers, with a tripod loop, and that's how I'm deploying it here. The interior is gusseted and has a sort of concertina design, which can take up to 10 filters, and it's really easy to use. So there we are, the SW150 system, a complete professional filter system for the ultra-wide angle photographer.